Sometimes
to have me, say, because I will live the rest of my life.
Come on, somebody. today to be a part of this momentous occasion. This is a double blessing to be able to celebrate. Somebody say celebrate. My mother's 70th birthday and also her appreciation at Faith in Action Church. So I thank God that I almost thought she wasn't going to make it. Somebody say, she wasn't. The devil thought she wasn't going to make it. Not me, but the devil thought. Hallelujah. He just planned on my mother not even making it to her 70th birthday. But I just thank God, hallelujah, that God stepped in. Just in time.
Amen.
Somebody say it, but just in time.
Just in time.
And he turned things around.
Amen.
So I told my mother, I said, Mama, if you start getting sick and having these pains, just let me know and I'll have Minister Cole to take you right on home. But she was determined to be here and I wanted her to stay home because my mother was so sick and weak that she really couldn't, you know, she just couldn't dress herself and she just really couldn't put one foot before the other. That's how weak and sick she is. But I just felt a need in my spirit. Somebody say, get down in here. That she needed to be here. I don't know what it is, but she just needed to be here tonight. And I don't know whether she's going to get a breakthrough or we're going to get a word. I just don't know, but I know that God's going to do something special. Right. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
God is going to do something different.
Hallelujah.
He's going to do something tonight.
Amen.
And I thank God for all of you, praise God, coming out tonight to be a part of this momentous occasion. I see a lot of, praise God, my friends, praise God, from Sherman, raise your hand, Sherman, Cordell.
Hallelujah.
Oh, look at God. Did I miss anyone from out of town? Sherman, Cordell, and Ashford, would you raise your hand? Anybody else from out of town? I want to recognize. Praise God. Hallelujah. We thank God for Ashford, Sherman, and Cordell. And we just thank God for all the pastors that came out, praise God, that helped me celebrate my mother. Oh, come on, somebody. I see Dr. Henry Brown. Will you raise your hand? Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Right in the front, praise God. I thank God for Pastor Green. Will you raise your hand? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I thank God for Minister Westbrook and Pastor Williams. Praise God. Will y'all raise your hand? The spouses. From Sherman, praise God. I thank God, hallelujah, for Pastor Knight, praise God, and her daughter, praise God, Minister. Praise God, and her, yes, her husband. We thank God, hallelujah, for them coming out tonight, and we thank God for everyone from Faith in Action. Will you please raise your hand, Faith in Action? Hallelujah. We thank God for all Big Mama, praise God. Family, praise God. Her sister, praise God. Her oldest sister sitting right beside us. Sister Long, will you raise your hand? Thank God, praise God, for her next older sister, Sister Jackson. Irene Jackson, you raise your hand. Her husband, praise God, Paradise. We thank God, praise God, for the baby sister. Oh, is she coming in, praise God? And I want this overlook on, praise God, because I know you all look at this program, y'all say, honey, it's a long program, but it's really not going to be that long, praise God, because it don't take y'all like to do anything. Ain't that right? So at this time, Poland, Georgia. I'm sorry, Poland, Georgia. It's Poland in the house.
Amen.
Raise your hand, Poland.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. At this time, praise God, we're going to have a short devotion from the House of Prayer by Faith Church. Praise God. At this time, we'll ask Professor Lavasky Brown to come forth, and they run us two selection, hot selection, praise God.
And then what? The glory. So the devil ain't gonna get nothing here. Somebody said the devil ain't gonna get nothing.
Yes,
no, he ain't getting nothing up in here. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Somebody bless the Lord with your hands today. Come on. Oh, come on. We can do better than that. That's not better. Somebody bless him. Hallelujah. Come on, let's shout it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Somebody bless him today. Come on. Somebody just worship him right now. Somebody give him glory. Give him the honor. Come on, give him the honor. Come on, why don't don't you just stand to your feet today and just give the Father in the blessing? Right now. And we honor you, Lord.
Sanctus of Peace. Praise God, we're going to call Pastor Johnny Gardner, the pastor of New Mount Holder, which is my oldest brother.
Amen.
To be the pastor.
Us another day.
Amen.
We love the Lord today. Let us bow our heads with a word of prayer. Oh, Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, God, we just say thank you right now. Lord, we thank you for your many blessings, God. We thank you for your many benefits today, Lord. Oh, God, we just ask you today to have your way right now, God. In this service right now, God, just glorify yourself even more. Oh, God, just have your way. Pour out your anointing, God. Thank you. Pour out your breaking power today in the name of Jesus. And, God, we just thank you right now. We come together to celebrate, Lord, our mother today, her birthday, God. And we just say thank you for it right now. Thank you for the 70 years, God. Thank you right now, Lord. She's been a good woman, God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Still up for what was right, God. And we thank you. Raise us, God. Thank you to love one another. Thank you, Lord. And we just glorify you right now. And Lord, we ask that you bless everyone that come out, God. Meet their needs one by one. Bless them with such blessing they stand in need of, God. In the name of Jesus, as we reach out to you right now, as we glorify you right now, Lord, as we praise your name right now, God. Oh, God, shower your blessings down upon your people today, God. Bring us in place. Put us in position that we need to be in, God. In the name of Jesus. And we thank you right now, God. And we thank you for everything you've already done, and we thank you for things you're going to do in the future, God. Oh, God, have your way right now. Have your way right now. Cut out the walls, God. In the name of Jesus, pull up the things that don't need to be planted, God. In the name of Jesus, put us on the right track, God, and help us to be all that you want us to be, God. In the name of Jesus, and we come against everything that's not like you, every hindrance, God, every spirit that want to raise its ugly head that's not of God, we bind it right now. We said whatsoever we bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and what we lose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. Oh God, we lose the working potential of your power right now, the Holy Ghost, God. Oh God, have your way right now. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Be lifted up right now. Be glorified. In Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus, we pray. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. Will you please remain standing for the scripture? We're coming from Pastor Willie James Hill.
Man.
Amen.
Love the Lord, you ought to say it again.
Amen.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
For he is worthy to be praised.
Amen.
What a mighty God we serve. For God, he is good all the time. God is good. Hallelujah. We'll be coming from the gospel according to St. John. The 14th chapter, we'll commence reading at the first verse. And we will find Jesus saying these words: let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself. That where I am, there ye may be also. And whither I go, ye know, and the way ye know. Thomas said unto him, Lord, we know not whither thou goest, and how can we know the way? Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. We have read you 6 verses of the 14th chapter of St. John. May God bless you with the word, and let us all continue to be doers.
Amen. Hallelujah for this program thus far.
Amen.
And I just, like I said earlier, I believe God's going to do something here tonight.
Amen.
But he's going to do it through us.
That's it.
So I'm asking you all, praise God, get a spiritual mind to praise God. Let us be sensitive.
That's it.
Somebody say, let us be sensitive.
Let us be sensitive
to the moving of God.
Amen.
Let us be sensitive to his voice.
Yeah.
Because his voice is not in everything.
Yeah.
Come on, somebody. So therefore, we must be sensitive. Hallelujah. So at this time, praise God, we're going to have, we're going to skip the selection and do the welcome and the give of the grandchildren. They're supposed to be doing a praise to Big Mama, great-grandchildren. Well, one is the great and one is the grand. So Aaron, raise your hand. So y'all look back at Aaron. She's the grand. And my granddaughter's the great-grand. Ain't that beautiful? Praise the Lord. So at this time, we're going to ask Sister Cynthia Fleming from Faith in Action to give us words of welcome. I know y'all are all from Faith in Action, and we thank Israel Temple for letting us have this occasion at you all sanctuary. And we thank God for Mother. You all are welcome here at Israel Temple. Anytime the doors are open, and you all are welcome at Faith in Action. Anytime the doors are open. For Big Mama, great grand, and grandchild, as they perform one selection of praise dance. Amen.
I could have lost in my mind.
Hey, all right.
Wanted to give up so many times. But God was mine.
All right.
A consistent way maker. Yes, I'm waiting. God covered me.
All right.
Go on and sing the song, Pastor.
Protection.
trying to move along kind of fast. Praise God, we got a lot we want to do. And Big Mama, praise God, we don't want to wear her out because she is really weak. And can y'all understand that? So y'all forgive me. It seems like I'm trying to rush through a little bit. But if the Spirit says stop, I need to stop. Ain't that right? So I am sensitive to the Spirit, praise God. So at this time, praise God, we're going to have the occasion by my second oldest brother, Pastor Apostle Jimmy L. Gardner, the pastor of this church, Israel Temple. Come on, give it up. Amen.
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 God is an awesome God.
Amen.
And I'm here to do the occasion and to look at my mother. Amen. I think about the many jobs that she had just for us.
Amen.
And I look at her, the scripture said, who can find a virtuous woman?
All right.
Amen.
Amen.
And I look at her and she is a virtuous woman. I'm not saying there's no one other women's out here. It's virtue. It's not virtue, but this is her night. Amen. She is a virtuous woman. She had seven boys and one girl. Two boys died in childbirth. Amen. And my tired daddy, he ran off and left us. And when he left us, the burden was all on mama. Amen.
Amen.
And mama said that she wasn't going to kill her daughter.
All right.
So mama made us learn how to wash. We didn't have no wash machine. Number 10 tubs and bathtubs and a rub bowl. We ain't have the firm mattress that you all have now. We had them things you had to stir up. And when you put that sheet on there, it better be smooth. Because it got a lump in it, she gonna tear it all up. So we had to learn how to smooth that mattress, make it look like it's a firm mattress. She taught us how to cook. Amen. And some of you look at us, say, no, she taught how to cook collard green fried chicken, cornbread. Hallelujah.
Yes, sir.
How to cook field peas, butter bean, rice. Because you say you might marry a woman that don't know how to cook. And you ain't going to be running over my house trying to get me to cook. So I'm teaching you how to do it. And I appreciate my mother for teaching me how to be what I am today. My mother is a blessed woman. Out of the eight, hallelujah, she got four pastors. Out of the eight. I consider that's a blessing. Because in Deuteronomy 28, it tells us that the fruit of your body shall be blessed. And he blessed. And I don't know about you, I don't take no defeat.
Mm-hmm.
The devil's going to have to lose her.
Oh, yeah. Amen. Come on,
Pastor. Thank you, Lord. And anyone else in here sick, because the message this morning said, God said he's going to bless her.
Amen.
And he said he's going to take away sickness out of the midst. So sickness cannot dwell in the house of God. And all we're going to have to say one day, if I could just make it to the house, if I could just take it to the house of God, everything. Oh, y'all ain't seen. Y'all gotta calm down. Y'all gotta calm down.
Thank you.
The occasion is for a virtuous woman who the devil trying to steal. Because the Bible says he come to steal, kill, and to destroy. Hallelujah. And see, God been having me on a fast.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. And getting up 3 in the morning, going down into the living room, getting on my face. Hallelujah. And I know I ain't getting up that early for nothing. And I know I'm not going out on my face for nothing. And I know I'm not turning down my plate for nothing. All I need is somebody to link up with me. Amen. Hey, thank you, Jesus. That's all I need, somebody that's to link up. Amen. And as we link up together, hallelujah. Because this is the year of the saints. Hallelujah. We gonna have what God say that we can have. And all we gotta do is decree a thing, and it shall come to pass. Do what you have in the saints in the house. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We are helpers one to the other. When you in trouble, I shall come to your rescue. When I am in trouble, you shall be to mine. Because we are sisters and brothers in the eyesight of God. I'm through with it. See, the devil ain't got no business having no field day on us. Hallelujah. We got too much anointing in these churches. We all might be in the same building. We might not even be in the same state. Hallelujah. But it's too much anointing that God is pouring out on the church. And we want to hog it to ourselves. You can't hog it to yourself. Look at your neighbor and say, you can't keep it to yourself. Yeah.
Thank God for that beautiful occasion. All I can say, well said. Hallelujah. And this time we're going to have a selection from the Divine Connection Ministry. Are you in the house? Divine Connection. Invitation. We ask that you limit your words of exhortation to 2 minutes or less. Unless the Holy Ghost. Come on, somebody. Unless the Holy Ghost take over. At this time, praise God, we're going to call Pastor Norman Pierce of Divine Connection. Are you in the house? From New Morning Star. Come on and give God a praise offering as he come forth.
You ought to shout glory. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I could stand here tonight and go on and on and on about a great lady. One whom I have learned how to love. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And I know what she been through.
All right.
And know what she going through.
All right. Amen.
Through by her children. When I met them,
yes,
they were the same every day.
All right.
And through by her daughter, I was introduced to her mother. Amen.
Amen.
And I want to say to Mother Redden tonight, a new tragedy have came into your life, amen, and took part of you away. And on that part, I know how you feel. Because the same thing happened to me. But I can say to you tonight, Mother Redding, keep looking to the hill which cometh your help. All your help cometh from the Lord. And then the word tonight is, God ain't through with you yet. I said, God is not through with you yet. You see, when something be through with, amen, it don't be finished. They got to run a car that through it back through the assembly line. Amen, and get it the proper word. But when it's finished, amen, it don't have to go back through the assembly line. He gonna send you back through the assembly line. Because he didn't bring you this far just to leave you. And it's important, my sisters and brothers, to have a mother.
Amen.
Amen. And I can say to you tonight, love your mother.
Amen.
Amen. With all your heart.
Amen.
Amen. And anything that Pastor Green and the New Morning Star could do, amen, I'm just a phone call away.
Amen.
Amen. And I say to you tonight, amen, keep trusting in God.
Yes.
Amen. And keep the faith.
Yes.
Amen. Because this race wasn't given to the swift, not the strong, but those that endure to the end. God bless you.
We thank Pastor Green for those one words exhortation. Praise God for him taking out from his busy schedule to be here. Could have been anywhere else, and all of you all the same. Could have been somewhere else, but I thank God that you sacrificing. Some came near and far, but I thank God that you all came tonight to be a part of this great occasion. And it's time we're going to call Pastor Robert Williams, praise God, from Living God, from the Church of the Living God, Gates of Heaven Church. Pastor Williams, come on, give God a praise offering for him. Came all the way.
Give God a hand praise up in here. Well, I believe y'all can do better than that. See, I believe this is a job for occasion. Well, we ain't got no dead in here. We got some living in this building. Oh, y'all ought to give God a praise in this place. Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody shout glory. Somebody shout praise him. Shout it again. Praise him. When you're having fun, you don't mind rejoicing. And this is supposed to be a joyful occasion. Amen, amen. Ain't no dead bone up in here.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jesus.
I believe I left some dead bones out there in the graveyard. But ain't no one up in here. Ain't nothing but the power of God up in this place. Somebody shout glory to God. Somebody shout praise his name. Well, I belong to a other group. And I believe in praising God. I thank God for the honorees. I thank God for all the poor people, all the ministers, and everyone that sits in the midst. If you're a child of God, I give you honor. If you're not a child of God, become one. I still give you honor. Amen. Ain't that all right? I never got a chance to meet the mother here today. And it's but I met her daughter. And it's some feedback. Do y'all understand that? I ain't got but 2 minutes, so I'm not used to being up 2 minutes. But so I'm going to hurry up and get out of the way. But I don't want to be sound like I'm a copycat or anything. But I woke up this morning. The Lord woke me up this morning at 3 a.m. this morning.
All right.
Now, if you was at my church early this morning, you'd have heard me tell them that. And the Lord put it in my spirit about healing.
All right.
And he carried me right to the woman with the issue of blood.
All right.
And when he carried me there, I just began to lay there and I began to meditate on the Lord. And he began to say they need healing.
Yes.
Not only in the body, but their mind, their soul. They need healing in the spirit. God will heal you. And I come to say today, and I'm sitting down, that today to you, mother, trust in the Lord as you always. You know her generation didn't start on last week.
All right.
She went through a lot of toils and tears to get here this day.
Amen.
She went through a lot of trials and tribulations just to get here this day.
Amen.
And I believe in her heart, she said, if I just can make it to the house of the Lord. If I just can get there, just make it 1 minute, 1 ounce, and 1 second. If I just can be like the woman, if I just can grab hold to the hem of his garment.
Hey, thank you, Jesus. Beautiful. Come on and put those hands together and praise the Lord. Thank you, wonderful Savior. Crystal, please, if I can just touch the hem, everything will be all right. Thank you, Jesus. At this time, we're going to call Pastor Dyke Marshall from Church of the Nazarene. Praise God.
Amen.
Come on, give God a praise offering for him. Pastor Marshall.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus. I ain't fooling me, are you? Hallelujah.
Spirit of expectancy is the breeding ground for miracles.
Come on now.
Oh, you didn't hear me. The spirit of expectancy is the breeding ground for miracles. The world calls it a self-fulfilling prophecy, but the word says you can speak those things that are not as if they were. I don't know about you this afternoon, this evening, or tonight, but I got a spirit of expectancy in my spirit, a spirit of expectancy down in my toes. I expect the impossible. Or there's a song that says, I'm looking for a miracle. I expect the impossible. I feel the intangible and I see the invisible. I look in. I got an expectancy. I know it's there. I don't see it. I can't feel it. But I step out on nothing and believe that something is there. We keep talking ourselves out of our miracles if we can just get an expectancy miracle. A spirit of expectancy. See? And some folks ain't been nowhere. But you see, you got to remember where God done brought you from. See, because Paul wrote, to him who was able to keep you. See, as a young man, it's a blessing for me to see a mother who God has kept. See, we got to treasure the memory and treasure those who have that inside of them, that future and past and present all together. So many, we try to do a new thing and we forget about the old thing. And we forget about what helped us get over. And we always want to jump up and do something new and forget about what got us to where we at. Anybody ever heard about dancing with the person who you brought you there? But when we get into trouble, we go dancing with something else and something new. And we want to put it in the microwave and hit start. Jesus told the disciples, these come but by fasting and praying. We don't even got fasting and praying saints no more. Because if you can't pop it in the microwave, you can't trust God, even though you can't see it and touch it. See, God told me this year. He said, it's already done. Everything that I promised you is already done. You got to wait for the manifestation. Y'all missed that. It's already done. Healing already done. Deliverance already done. Family members saved already done. Finances healed already done. Houses and cars already done. It's already done. I don't care what you think. It's already done. It's already done. It's already done. All you got to do is shout. All you got to do is pray. All you got to do is give him glory and wait for his manifestation to show up in your life. Because he said, I inhabit the praise of my people. So if you want the manifestation, get up off your show nuff and get on your show nuff.
Woo! Look at God. I say, look at God. Hallelujah. Look at God. How many enjoying Jesus? Amen. We're getting a word here tonight. Hallelujah. This time we're going to have two selections from Big Mama Grands and Great Grands. Hallelujah. Come on, bring your hands together and praise the Lord for me and say, come on.
And I said, we'll call her Big Mama. And it wasn't because she was so big, but she did things very big. I mean, we had a big family, had big cookouts, had everything was big. So I thought it was fitting. Amen. We are just getting together right now to do something. And no matter what we can do, we cannot do enough to show appreciation. So we're going to do the very best that we know how to do under the circumstances. Amen? So we're going to do a song that she loved so much growing up. I was growing up when she was younger. And it's called Trouble in My Way.
Trouble in my way.
and I'm growing more and more each day. Thank you.
this is not even half of them. Praise God, we just a portion. Big Mama got a big family. That's why they call her Big Mama, not because of her size, but because of what Big Mama has. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Big Mama used to be kind of big, but Big Mama done lost a lot of weight. So we got to change that to Little Mama. Is that all right? Amen. So let's give God another praise offer for them. Yeah. Thank you, Jesus. It's Bible Way in the house. Bible Way praise dances. Are you in the house? Amen. If not, praise God, we're going to move right along and we're going to take up the seed of giving, praise God. We're going to give you an opportunity at this time to plant a seed in Big Mama's. At this time, praise God, we're going to have words of exhortation coming from Pastor Henry M. Brown, House of Prayer by Faith. Come on, let's give it up for Pastor Brown.
Thank the Lord. Amen. I was sitting back there tonight, amen, seeking the Lord, because when I stand before his people, I want to be in his perfect will. Amen. I want to say what he wants me to say, and I want to do what he wants me to do. Amen. Because it's not about us. It's not about you. It's not about me. It's about Jesus. Amen. Amen. We want to say tonight, we love you, Sister Redden. Amen. We love you. Amen. And we appreciate you. Amen. Amen. And we are praying for you. I was sitting back there thinking about a word to say, and the Holy Spirit put in my heart, amen, to sing a song that he gave me over 30 years ago. Jesus is going to pay every man according to his work.
And I want y'all to pray much for me. I'm not saying that I'm
when she tell me don't leave her, and she know that I got to be in church, and she always telling me, praise God, don't ever let me keep you from going to the house of God and do your work. But I knew she had to be real sick for her to tell me, don't leave. Then she began to tell me this. I want y'all to hear this. She said, Glover, I want you to take care of my sons.
Yes.
I said, Mama, I want to hear you talk like that. She said, I want you to take care of my baby. She still call them baby. Right. They all is Methuselah. All of us just about in our 50s and 40s, she ain't got nobody in the 30s. But she said, Gloria, I want you to take care of my babies. And I'm sitting there, Sarah, I said, man, she got a lot of girls to take care of her baby. Who's going to take care of me? I say, it's more of them than it is me. You should be telling them Ty Jones to take care of me. But I say, nevertheless, Mom, if I got the strength and the power, I'll take care of your lot of head children. I'm just saying it comical, but I was crying this morning. But I thank God today, tonight, brother, that I can smile.
Amen.
Because I know that day is coming that we got to depart, because God only promised us 70.
Yes.
He done did what he said.
Yes.
So if she don't say, see tomorrow or even to the end of the night, I thank God for right now.
Yes.
I asked God to let her see her birthday and celebrate Friday night. She celebrated Friday night and six of dogs Saturday and six of dogs today, but she pressed away and came in a high.
Yes.
So God let me, oh y'all don't hear me. Let me see his grace in operation. Oh, somebody say, we need to see his grace. We need to be sensitive to his grace in operation. I say, this is God's grace. Sitting over here in his comb. Come on, somebody. Although she drifted off sometime, but guess what? She's still here. And I thank God, if she don't get to see my 55th birthday, which is next month, the 28th of April, if she don't even get to see my birthday, I thank God he let her live to see her own birthday. I thank God for my mom. I love my mom. And I can see that you all love my mama too. And if y'all got moms, I love y'all moms. Amen. Hallelujah. I just don't know, having a mother is a joy. And my brothers have always told me that me and my mama being so close, that if something happened to Big Mama, me, you have to dig two holes. But now that I've grown in grace, I don't know about that. Because I know I got much work to do. Come on, somebody. And I can't sit around and pout and have a pity party when God got something for me to do. Come on, somebody. How many know we just got to grow up? Come on, somebody. Got to suck it up and go on. Come on, somebody. Oh, y'all don't hear me. Hallelujah. And she even told me, Pastor Lyne, she said, if you're going to cry, she said, don't cry in front of me. She said, go in the bedroom somewhere and cry and come back and with your face all fixed up. I just took my little tail and went on back there and finished crying. Then I came and I, Mom, would you go? It's morning now, but this morning, praise God, I tell you the truth, I seemed like I was a funeral in her bedroom. But I pulled myself together somewhere. I know it was God. I was leaning on his arms and riding on the seal of his love, and he got me, praise God, that I was able to come on out tonight to MC this program. And so, somebody please come on and praise the Lord with me. Put your hands together. And this time we're going to call Pastor Alfred Robinson from Reach Out and Touch Ministry of Americas, Georgia. Let's put your hands together and give God some praise for this wonderful man of God. Go back a long ways down with Pastor.
And let the people of God say amen.
Amen.
I'm going to say amen again.
Amen.
I do give honor to the Spirit of Christ tonight. And Mother Reddick, I'm certainly overflowing right now. Amen. I thank God for this program. I thank God for what her daughter and her sons, what they're doing here, calling you all together, us all together, that we might celebrate with her tonight. A 70th birthday. Let's give God a hand for that. Amen. That's a blessing. I still got my mama and my daddy. Mama 71, daddy 76. Sometimes I think they're in better shape than me. And I thank God for them. I know the day now will come that God will call them. But we buried my wife's mother about a month ago. Amen. Her daddy passed when she was a year old on her birthday. But I thank God that she still got me in the Lord. Can you say amen?
Amen.
It's a blessing to have parents, a blessing to have someone that you can love and cherish, and someone that you can trust in. And certainly parents are jewel to us. Mother, keep on keeping on for the Lord. And, you know, I guess sometimes I look at death a little different than some people. The Bible said that Jesus is the God of the living, but he's the God of the dead. Come on now.
Amen.
The Bible said that he's in heaven. And the Bible said that he's in hell. Huh? And I know it on the earth because he in me. So I thank God. Mother, when the Lord call you home, I may get there before you do. But if you get there before I do, tell him I'm on my way.
Yeah.
Come on now. Amen. I thank God, amen, that there are a lot of folk we look and think they figuring to go. You don't know what God figuring to do. God is God. God is not a man. He's a God. And I thank God tonight, amen, that I didn't come down here to lift up Mother Reddick. I know she ready for whatever he got. I come down to be a blessing to the family, to my little sister there. Come on, say amen. Come down and let you know that Jesus loves us. And he will never make any mistake when it comes down to our welfare. Can you say amen?
Amen.
I look at Sister Paula back here. I think about a story. And I got 2 minutes. I'll sit down on a minute. Well, you know, us pastors are a little hard-headed. We all, you know, we preach a while, mill a while, and finally we shut up. But I thank God for Sister Paula. She reminds me of the story of Ruth and Naomi.
All right.
You know, Ruth was not Naomi's daughter. She was just married to her son.
All
right. Naomi and her husband, her two sons, decided to leave home and go off to see if they could make a living.
Uh-huh.
And when they got off down in the strange land to make a living, they died, all three of them.
Right.
Husband and her two boys. But I thank God that them boys married before they died.
Yeah.
Naomi and the other girl, can't think of her name.
Orpha,
thank you. Can't remember Orpha, because Orpha wasn't faithful.
That's right.
You forget about the unfaithful ones. But the Bible said that Ruth would not leave her mother-in-law.
That's right.
And Naomi told her, honey, I don't have nothing. So I don't have no inheritance for you. I'm poor, I'm broke. And now I'm headed back home to see if my kinfolk will do anything for me.
All right.
But Ruth told her, I won't leave you. I'm going to stay with you no matter what. And the word goes on to say that when they got back home, said Ruth stayed with her. And they didn't have anything. And Naomi told her, said, listen, it's time for you to go now. She said, I'm too old to get pregnant again. Right. They have more babies. And if I have another baby, by the time he get old enough for you to marry, you'll be too old to marry. But she said, I still won't leave you. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Oh, and the Bible said that this young pretty girl, she would go out every morning, mother, and she would go in the fields, and she would glean in Boaz's fields. She didn't have no field to pick in. So when the pickers come through, oh, I'm getting happy now. And when they come through and get all of the, you know, the, can I say like I want to?
Yeah.
When they pick all the corn,
yeah.
And when they pick all the peanuts,
come on
now,
yeah.
They will leave just a few fragments behind.
Yeah.
And the Bible said that Ruth would go behind the pickers and she would gather up fragments.
Yeah.
And one day the Bible said that Boaz looked out and saw this pretty girl and said, who is that woman?
Yes.
Out there gathering fragments. My God, they said that's Ruth's daughter-in-law.
Uh-huh.
Oh, I ain't got time to tell the whole story. But the Bible said that when she find favor in his sight,
yes.
Hallelujah. Lord, she wind up married in the same field that she gleaned in. Now she owned it.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes. And I say to you, Sister Paula,
God, see your faithfulness. Yes. See, all children are faithful to the parents. See, when mama got money in her pocket, can you say amen? Yes. I said, when mama got money in her pocket, she got a house for you to live in. Yes. Thank the Lord. And she got a bank account for you to gleam off. Yes. You can find them. And they come around. But when you get sick, mother, hallelujah, in your old age, and you still got one, you still got two, three, four, hallelujah, my God and mighty God in their pocket, hallelujah, and seeing about you, it's a blessing, and I thank God, mother, that when I get old in age, I pray God that my babies, y'all don't hear me tonight, thank the Lord. Oh, I pray God that my babies will come and see about their day. Hallelujah. Can I have a half or more second? Just half a second. Hallelujah. He said, Lord, I call Mother Robinson home tonight. I don't know when he gonna call, but when he call, I'm gonna have a testimony that when she was alive, I went to a house. I saw about if she needed a punch bill, I build. If she needed brass cut, I cut it. If she needed a bill paid, I paid. Can you see? Yes, yes. I thank God for mother like Naomi. Naomi, you've been a good woman. So when the Lord call you, it may be tonight, maybe tomorrow, maybe 10 years from now. But know this, you got a roof. Thank the Lord. God don't hear me tonight. Hallelujah. Mother, I don't know you, but I pray that you got a roof somewhere to see about you. Can you see? And if you don't have a roof, I pray you got a Boaz. Thank the Lord. See, Boaz was a husband cousin. Can you see him? He wouldn't come to a rescue when a husband friend died. But because of Ruth. Hallelujah. Lord have mercy. Can you say amen? Oh, I'm getting happy here. And the Holy Ghost tell him, all right, that's enough now. That's enough now. Amen. Come on, give the Lord a hand. Come on, give him a hand. I thank God for mother. Hang in there, mother. Hang in there. The Lord loves you. You've been a blessing to your children. I've been knowing these kids for years. And you all have always respect your mom. And I thank God for that. I thank God for you, mother. The Lord bless you. Amen. You are my testimony. Come on, give the Lord a hand.
Amen. Come on, put those hands together. Praise the Lord for those words. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. It's Pastor Thomas Henry in the house. It's Pastor Thomas Henry of Christian Life Church. Pastor A.J. Neely. Miracle Revival. Pastor Johnny Leggett, Abundant Life. Amen. We're going to move right along. Praise God. You're about to reach out and touch praise dancers or the choir. Yes, amen.
I'm missing. It's Brother Leon. You all know who I'm talking about. Amen. And all the grandkids. Thank you.
triple selection, praise God, that Jesus will not leave us.
Amen.
We leave Jesus, he never leaves us. Amen. Amen. If you're looking for Jesus, he's where you left him at. Come on, somebody. I ain't trying to be sarcastic, but he's where you left him at. Amen. At this time, my mother requests, praise God, that we bring on our special group, praise God, the William Jones and Rhema Gospel.
Amen.
Praise God. I'm like, amen. Come on, bring your hands together. Praise the Lord for them. At this time, her request is dripping and dropping. Amen. And answer, they do one selection, praise God, now, and then we're going to make the presentation to Big Mama because I think that she's getting sick. And then we do the...
Yes. Can you see it? Can you see it? Can you see it? See it? Let's go to Big right. Mama. Well, God told no. Oh,
got to get to know him for yourself. When he came back, when he gets back, he's not gonna show no mercy. The reason why he's not gonna show no mercy all this time, you have a chance to know it for yourself. Don't waste it. He's coming back. All that screaming, all that hollering, kill right on.
But before we do, I want to recognize, I want them to come up here, right across here. Praise God, our oldest sister, praise God, Sister Lawton. Her next oldest sister, praise God, Sister Jackson. And her baby sister, praise God, Sister Moses. I want them to come right across here so y'all can see her sister. Sister Lawton and her baby sister, praise God. They have been a great inspiration in helping me with Big Mama. Coming out to the hospital to stand overnight. They've been such a great inspiration. I thank God for her three sisters sticking by her. She got another sister, what her name?
Nadine.
I'm trying to think of her last name, Turner. I ain't trying to be smart, I forgot her last name, Turner. I wanted to, you know, recognize as their last name. Up in New Jersey, and then she have a brother also, Marvin, in New Jersey. Then she got two here, Kay Wood and Arthur. Ain't that right? So we just thank God for them being in our midst tonight. Come on, give God a praise offering for them. Amen. And at this time, I want to recognize Big Mama Children. Amen. Big Mama Children. Start with the oldest, praise God, Pastor Johnny Gardner. Will you please stand right here? Pastor Jimmy Gardner. Oh, I'm sorry. Did I say he's the oldest? I said, I'm the oldest, but I'm sorry. I forgot I'm the oldest. I tell you the truth, but I forget my head around my neck. But anyway, I thank God for, let's see, who next is Brother Joe, he's not here. The next one is Leon, he's not here. And who else? Willie Jane. Come on, Willie Jane. Come on, Bam. They call him Too Sweet. Come on, he's just too sweet. Amen. We thank God for him. And the knee baby, praise God, brother Rick. Amen. They call him Slick Rick. And the baby is operating the camera. Praise God, brother Kennedy Johnson. Come on, baby, bro. He the baby. Can y'all believe that? He the baby, all of us. 7 boys and 1 girl. Praise God. They call me Sister Mama. Amen. So I just thank God that I'm able, praise God, to be a part of the family, praise God. I really love and I appreciate and I'm proud of my brothers. So at this time, praise God, we got all the brothers now. I want the grandchildren. I'm sorry, the wives. That's right. Y'all help me now. Help me. Where's, first of all, my husband, my better half. Come on, baby. This is Big Mama, only son-in-law. Amen. The first gentleman. Amen. Amen. Sister Gardner, praise God. The first lady of Newmount Holden. This is Pastor Gardner's wife. Amen. Apostle Jimmy Gardner, Sister First Lady, Sister Gardner, Gladys Gardner. Bishop Temple. We do thank and praise God for Pastor Leon Gardner and his absent First Lady, Sister Gardner. Amen. Praise God, and their absent, praise God, tonight. Let's give God a praise offering for them in their absence. Praise the Lord. Praise God. The next, praise God, is my brother Willie, his fiance and her absent, praise God. She would have been here, but she got scalded with grease. But we still want to recognize them because they're going to get married as soon as he gets some things straight. Let's give God a praise offering for her and her offering, absent. And my sister-in-law, praise God, Sister Barbara, praise God, this is Slick Rick wife. Amen. But it's all right to have fun, ain't it? I'm so tired of y'all all squished up like a French fry. Praise God. We thank God for my baby brother, praise God. His wife is operating the camera. Sister Jackie. Amen. So, all right, I want my children to come, Jamon and Rachel. Minister Jamon Pollard. And my daughter Rachel, where is she? Minister Rachel, let her prophesy. If it's a lie, it'll come to pass. Come on. This is, amen. This is my daughter, Rachel. I got 2 children. Praise God. I want y'all to know who we are. Praise God. My daughter and my son. Amen. All right. Next, Brother Johnny. Is Keisha here? Matthew is in the military, and Keith is in Atlanta. Amen. So we'll recognize them. Amen. I'm sorry, Miranda, will you please stand, baby? This is Keith's wife. I mean, Matthew's wife. Raise your hand, baby. She gone? Okay, then. All right, then. Next is, you ain't got no grandchildren.
Amen.
Amen. So we're going to call Kenosha. He got some children, though. He got Kenosha, Mark. What era? Era didn't come. Okay, era is in Atlanta. And then Ann is in Columbus. Amen. So next we have, who's next? Willie, okay. He got 2 children. They in Virginia, April and Andrea. Nope, oh, he got 1 grandchild. We might as well just going to say. They already grandchild, praise God. We thank God for my brother Rick. He got 3 children. Is getting them mixed up.
JR.
Come on, JR. J.R. Bontresa, Tiffany. You stay back there. Come on up, baby. Did I omit anybody? Okay, Antonio. I'm sorry, Antonio. Did I omit anybody? All right, it goes down to Kennedy right now. Kennedy got 1 child. Aaron, where Aaron at? Come on up, Aaron.
And Kim is here for Pastor God.
Okay, well, just a minute. I'm going to get there. Amen. Amen. So we're going to have Kim and Cheryl to stand in for Pastor Leon Gardner.
She had to leave.
Where's Cheryl? She had to leave. And then Ashley is in Savannah. And then Missy is in Japan.
That's right.
Amen. That's right. She in Japan. Amen. Praise God. Praise God. And so, amen. So these are her children. That's Pastor Leon Garner's grands. Cher has two. Missy has one. Ashley have none. Amen. So is that everybody? I don't want to omit everybody. So this is a portion of Big Mama family. Will you bring your hands together and praise the Lord? Amen. Amen. Praise God. We want to recognize Big Daddy on his sister. Want her to come up here. His only sister, praise God. Amen, that's living. Sister Maddie Frost, I'm going to get her. Amen. Will you bring your hands together and praise the Lord for Big Mama only sister-in-law. Amen. Don't she look foxy? Amen. Amen. And we thank God for Big Daddy, granddaughter, Wanda, and a great-grand. Now, they come from Tallahassee. They came all the way from Tallahassee. Come on, baby. Lene and her fiance. They came all the way. Little cousin came all the way from Tallahassee. They came Friday. They had to go back. They came back today, and they got to go back tonight. Amen. Did I omit anybody? I want to make sure I got all been. Okay. Amen. I forgot. Amen. Forget my own grandchildren. Ain't that something? They back there just waving their hand. Thank God for my daughter-in-law. Praise God. Minister Sabrina, come on up, Sabrina. And my two grandchildren, JJ and Precious, I rename all my children. And my daughter children, Bunny and Clyde. But, excuse me, I call her Bunny and Clyde. But this Tay Tay and Dory. Amen. Did I omit anybody?
Paradise.
All right, I'm sorry. Paradise, this, come on, baby. Come on. This is my aunt's husband. Sister Jackson, husband. Oh, yeah. Come on, Muffin. This is my aunt's granddaughter. Sister Jackson's granddaughter, Muffin. Amen. And she, I don't want to go through all that because I'm just all confused, y'all. I'm just confused. That's right. So I just thank God for a portion of my family. Amen. And Big Mama cousin. I'm sorry, I forgot. Praise God. And then come on up. Amen. Her cousin. They first cousin. Amen. So we thank God. And the other Big Mama folks. Pastor Brown. Amen. Here, distant folks. Come on up, Pastor Brown. Here, distant folks. Amen. So we just thank God. Let's give God a praise offering. Praise God for Big Mama family. And at this time, praise God, before Big Mama get worn out, we want to go ahead and make presentations. So any of the family members, why are you standing? Amen. All I can say, he's the ugly duckling, you know. I'm just kidding. Thank God for Pastor Brown. Listen up, y'all. Any of you that want to go ahead and make presentation, give to Big Mama, just stand in line and just go ahead and just take a half a minute and say what you got to say. And give her flowers while she yet lives so she can see and smell the beauty. Amen. At this time, the floor is open. Y'all can stand in line and just go one by one, and then we'll open up for the rest of the people in the audience if they want to make presentation. Amen. We're giving you all space if y'all want to have some sins. If I was you, I wouldn't put off tonight for tomorrow or next week or next month. I do what I need to do. I go on and do it tonight. Is that fair warning? Amen. We want to maximize the moment. Want to maximize the moment. We thank God for Pastor Willie Jane Hill. He got to go, praise God, from New Mount Zion, praise God, in Poland. Thank God for First Lady Sister Hill and all the church members that came from Poland. Amen.
All we have to say is just keep your heads up.
and give God the glory. And no matter what the situation is, just learn to be content and let God have his holy way. And that way is always the right way. Let's give God some praises.
Amen. Thank you so much. Amen. Praise God. Amen. Praise God. I think that's so sweet. Because let me just say this. When you're laying up cross here, nothing you can say but amen. Amen. Come on, they can't hear, they can't see, they can't smell. So we need to praise God to let people know how we feel. Oh, come on, help me here. Pastor Pierce, give God a praise offering for him. He's back in the bag. I thank God for you. Amen. I had called your name, but we'll give you space to have some sins, okay? Amen. Praise God. You just come on up here with the family as we make presentations and remarks. If that ain't Jesus, don't answer. You know I had to throw that in. I heard somebody else say that, Pastor. Amen. As you can see on your program, it's family and friends. So it's not limited just to the family. Anybody else that wants to have some sayings to Big Mama at this time, please feel free to do so. Amen. We had a little special gift for Big Mama, but the lady that was doing them, from my understanding, had death in the family, and she couldn't get them done. We in the process of making some fans with Big Mama picture. How many saw Big Mama picture on today's show, today in Georgia? Amen. Raise your hand if you're sure. Amen. Amen. Did she look good? Amen. She looked real good. Amen. Praise God. Praise God. Thank you, sir. Praise God. Amen. Okay, let's go ahead. Come in. Just go ahead. To me or somebody. Okay. Amen. Praise the Lord. Come on up, baby.
Why you talking? Big Mama, this is for you. This is just a small token of my enormous love I have for you. The fact that because of you, I have been set on the right track. Because I'm a member of your son, Pastor Johnny Gartner's church. And I thank God for my pastor. And I also praise and thank God for the woman who made the man.
All right.
So thank you, and I love you.
Amen.
You my big mama, too.
Come in.
Big mama, this is the token of my love. And let you know how much I love you. I never stop loving you. Because I didn't come and visit that this girl, I didn't love you. I always love you. Always. And I'm a pastor. I mean, I'm a member of your son. Church. Pastor Johnny Gardner.
Amen.
And I will always love you. Would you remember that? Love you so much.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
As you know, 4 months ago, I lost my husband. And Big Mama has been a very big encouragement to me. She's given me a lot of wisdom. She's just been there for me, her and Pastor. And I just want to say happy birthday to you, and I love you.
Thank you.
I also have two other presentations I'd like to give. I'd like to give one to my pastor because it's a poor frog don't praise their own pond. And I thank God for her because she's been there with me every step of the way. And this is for her. And I also want to give one to Brother William Jones and your group. Thank God for you all. And just keep up the good work. God bless you all.
I just want Cousin Mary to know I love her. And as a little girl, she's been my inspiration, man. Cousin James, I want you to know that we're pulling for you. And her and my husband. My husband is also, he's battling the same illness that she's battling. He goes back in the 13th. He sent his blessings to you, Cousin Mary. He went back to the hospital today. So he wants you to know that he loves you and both of y'all rooting on the same team. So we love you.
Bless you, Sandretti. One of your favorite songs is When I See Jesus. It'll be amen. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. May God bless you and continue to keep you. And I'll never stop loving.
I just want to say I love you. He was our first lady for about 20 years.
Amen.
And I always love him.
God bless you, Mama Betty. We love you. You are my inspiration. When your son walked into our church, that's when we got to meet you. But I had met you when you was, your husband was the pastor of the church in Poland, Mount Zion. I thank God for you, Mama Betty. I see some strong children that you have given birth to. All those strong boys and Sister Paula. It's a big inspiration in our lives. And I thank God for you. I thank God for him giving you Pastor Gardner. Because he's a strong man of God. And I know God knows what's best. Just keep on keeping on. Keep your head up. We love you. God love you, baby.
Thank you, Jesus.
Everything gonna be alright. Everything
gonna be alright.
I thank God for being here tonight. I thank God for Sister Redding because she has been an inspiration for me. When I came to Georgia 10 years ago, my husband started to pastor in Worth County. And at that time, she was a pastor's wife. I thank God for being an aid for me, that she was. I thank God for every time I saw her, she was always the same. I thank God for the song that her grandson sang tonight, because that was the first time that I saw her. She was singing that, she led that song at the first African Baptist church in Doran, I think it was. Troubles in my way. I have to cry sometimes. Many times we had conversations together. Many times I was sad because, just in case you all don't know, you don't understand what I'm trying to say. I'm trying to fight back the tears from my eyes because who knows, who knows, who knows? I'm battling, I'm faced with the same problems in my life that she is. That's what the doctor says. The doctor told me 5 years ago I had a cancer. And I lived 5 years. Amen. Pastor John Gardner. And I fell in love. You know what? I didn't have to learn I'm not here to preach or nothing like that, but I just want to get this. If you let me, I'd like to say this. Because I'm encouraged by this family. This Gardner family is some family.
That's it.
You understand what I'm saying?
That's it.
If we had more families in Southwest Georgia as the Gardner's family is, I think we wouldn't have as many problems as we would. Because we wouldn't have so many children running around on drugs and things according to the way that she taught her children. My God. I claim her children. I claim them for my sisters and brothers. And I claim them for my own children. And I said to each one of them, especially Pastor Johnny Gardner, that he's under my wing and he's never going to get away from me. Because I claim him as mine. Me and my husband, we love the Gardners. Wherever and every time we get a chance to come, we go where the Gardners are. You see this lady sitting right here? This is some lady right here.
Amen.
She's touched many people's lives.
Yes, yes.
Not only her children, she touched lives. She's like 1 year older than me. And the Bible talks about older ladies teaching younger women. I don't think you have to be 100 years old to be able to teach somebody something. If you don't grow to be old, 100 years old, and still don't know how to teach nobody nothing because you think you young, you ain't going nowhere. My Lord, I'm just going to go on and say, you be encouraged because the Lord is on your side. The doctor told me I had a cancer. You remember what you told me? Stand on the word. Don't let nothing stop you from trusting God. My Lord, don't let it be said that you ever gave up on God.
All right.
My Lord, I thank him tonight. And this is just a little token from Pastor and Sister Tima. And this little praise has been in my mouth. Pastor Jimmy, ever since I walked in here, I don't know if I can sing it, but it's in my heart. Because trust me, the word of God, I hear it in my heart. And let me tell you something. Let's don't take this for granted tonight. Don't be just sitting here looking. Because when Jesus left to go back to his Father, that's exactly what the people were doing. They were just standing there gazing. Just gazing. After he done told them all about his Father, that what he had to come here to do. And when it's over, it's going to be over. But I might be gone before she go. So don't set your heart on my mama going to be going tonight. Who knows? My God, the Spirit come to make alive. That's what you said. I heard you say that when you come in here today. Said that the Lord said healing was in this building. And guess what? Sometimes the Lord has to wait. Do you hear what I'm saying, Pastor Jimmy?
Yes, ma'am.
He had to wait until the hindrance get out of his way. My Lord, that could be what he's waiting for. So don't get in no hurry. Don't you dare be in no hurry. Let's see what God is going to say. And I thank him tonight. And this little song says, when I see Jesus, amen. When I see Jesus, amen. In all my troubles will all be over. When I see Jesus, amen.
Amen. Amen. Come on, bring those hands together and praise the Lord. Thank you, my Father.
Thank you.
Thank you, my Father. Thank you, my Father. Thank you, my Father. Her son-in-law want to have something to say.
Like, so, you know, what I'm going to say, amen. You know, it's good that parachute that she got. She got a parachute. And that reminds me of this. And I'm going to leave this with you. It's one time this man had a pain, and he had about four friends that he liked to take up every week. And take a fly out of his plane. Okay, and a doctor, a lawyer, a priest, and a little that always, everybody, when he bailed out, he had a backpack. So, don't know.
Do is she wants something done, right, okay, and with power.
I want to say I don't have a voice, Big Mama, but in obedience, I want to do as much as I can. The devil attacked my body today, but I made my way, and I just want to say that I love you for you, and dedicate this song to you, Wind Beneath My Wings. It must have been cold there in our shadows to never have sunlight on your face. You were content to let us shine. That's your way. You always walked that way. Now we were the ones with all the glory. All the strength, yes, you were a beautiful face to hide the pain for so long. Yet we never once heard you complain. Did you ever know that you're our hero?
She was forced, but look at the Holy Ghost. Then the Holy Ghost step in.
I rose to say, Mother, one of the greatest testimony that I ever heard was from Mother. And as she was testifying, I just want you, just a few minutes. As she was testifying, I said that you know, a lot of wives should hear what she had to say concerning her husband.
Come on, you can do better than that. Give God a hand clap of praise. Oh, come on, clap your hands like you know you have the victory tonight. Somebody say hallelujah. Come on and say glory to God. Amen. We're so grateful tonight to be here and help celebrate this woman of God. Birthday. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord, for truly the presence of the Lord is in this place. Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And we do give honor to, amen, the pastor of this church. Amen. And all of the rest of the men and women of God. Amen. We do give honor to God. Amen. To, amen, this great woman of God, Pastor Pollard. Amen. And first, I must say that I commend you very highly, amen, just for what you do. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Amen. And just for how you stick with, amen, your mom. Come on here, somebody. Y'all come on here. Amen. I esteem you. I esteem you very highly. And I also esteem your husband, amen, for allowing you to, y'all ain't talking to me. Y'all don't want to be real. Y'all looking deep now, right? Amen. But I esteem you because I know how it is. My grandmother dealt with the same thing that a mother is dealing with. And me and my mother and my father, amen, we were just the ones that were always there. Come on here, somebody. Amen. We were always there. Amen. Family, you know, they would come and you know, they would do their things. But it's something just when you're just the one that's always there. Come on here, somebody. Amen. It wears on your body. Amen. But I want you to know that God is giving you all a supernatural strength. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Amen. He is giving you a supernatural strength. Amen. So we thank God for you all and all the rest of the family. And mother, I just want you to know, amen, that we love you. I'm sorry that we were late, but amen. We were in the middle just having some crazy church. Y'all ever had crazy church? Me and Elder Brock tried to leave 3 times. Amen. But we were just having some good church. Amen. But I had to come by. Amen. And just let you know, mother, that we love you. Amen. And I preached a message on tonight. Amen. And my subject was, amen. I really don't even think I really gave a subject. Amen. Elder Brock is shaking his head. But basically, I was saying, either way, we win. Oh, Lord, y'all. I wish I had those signified. Lord, help me in here. Lord, if I was at home, we would have danced off of that one. Amen. But that's what, either way, we win. Amen. And that's what I come to tell you, but either way, oh, y'all ain't saying nothing here. Either way, somebody say either way. Either way. Everybody is talking about how much of a woman of God you are. My God. And everybody is talking about how much of an inspiration you are. Amen. How you have lived a life of a virtuous woman. And the only thing I can tell you is either way. Either way, we win. Family, keep that in your mind. Either way. Oh, yes, sir. Hallelujah. Amen. You are more than a conqueror. Either way. Come on here, somebody. You are healed either way. Your miracle has taken. You know, for us to be so saved, it's mighty funny. None of us don't want to go to heaven.
Somebody go here.
All right now.
I say for us to be so saved, Pastor, don't none of us want to go to heaven. If heaven is how great as we claim it is, then why in the world don't we want to go? But somebody say, either way, we win. That's what I want you to know. Either way, we win. How many people know, amen, to live is Christ, and to die is gain. Either way, we win. If I stay here, you're going to see my life. Come on here.
amen, that I'm giving glory to God. And if I leave, my soul is in heaven. Either way, y'all. Somebody say hallelujah. Somebody say hallelujah. Say it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So woman of Canada, hallelujah. Hallelujah. We esteem you highly. Amen. For the life that you have lived. But let me tell you something. You already got what God promised. 70 years is what God promised in his word. You got what he promised, y'all. Y'all hear what I'm saying? And then the devil, his crazy self, he said, now she done live so holy, I ain't gonna let her live to see Sunday night. But the devil didn't know somebody was praying. Come on here, somebody. I said, the devil didn't know somebody was praying. Come on here, somebody. We went there to see in the hospital, and I told my wife when we left, I said, and then I'm gonna sit down, but I feel something now. Y'all around here crying. Y'all better start rejoicing. Come on here, somebody. And I'm not just saying that, but you know we're going to bed. I live through it. Come on here, somebody. I've been there. Come on here. Amen, somebody. You better start rejoicing. Amen. I told my wife, I said, baby, you know the devil got a plan. She said, what is it? I said, you know, I said, as a Sunday night, she'll have what God promised.
Jesus.
Y'all ain't saying that.
Amen.
I said, the devil trying to get.
Come on.
Oh, child, Lord, help me. Trying to abort what God has promised.
Come on.
So you know what me and my wife started doing? We started binding the abortion. No, shut up. I said, we started.
Come on now.
Y'all looking real deep over here. We started binding the abortion. And we start saying she gonna get what God promised.
That's right.
And she is here tonight.
All right.
Either way, we win.
Yeah.
Pastor Pollard, either way,
we win.
We win. God bless you.
I receive.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Praise God. Big Mom, they have something to say, just one or two words.
I thank God for everything that you all have came out and done for me tonight. And I just praise God for Jesus that he's the author and the finisher of my faith. And I want to bring back what Minister Tima said. What he said in this church tonight, it was so true. We had a lot of problems during that time, and I know he was the man of the household, but you know how some people get when they're the head of something, they just take it over. They just take over everything. So I just let him know that he wasn't going to run over me, you know. So when he would go out and stay and do his little thing and come back, then I'm full of fire.
That's it.
Fighting fire.
All right.
You know. And so then I would let him know that I ain't gonna stand for it. I'm human just like you. You know, I got feeling. You treat me like a wife, and I treat you like a husband.
All right.
So then he saw that he wasn't going nowhere where he was doing it. He let me have a part of it, too. And we've been had a part of it since he left.
All right.
And I don't want no husband no more. I just want to live the few days I got for Christ. So you all that want him, y'all go get him. I don't want him. So I thank and praise God for Jesus today for being my father. And y'all take care, and thank you all again for the lovely gifts and the flowers and the cards and everything. I want you to know that I love y'all, and God bless.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Praise the Lord. At this time, praise God. I know I had promised them they could do one more song, praise God, but we're going to go ahead and dismiss. And then we let, if y'all don't mind, y'all sing a song after we dismiss. Amen. Is that all right?
Amen.
Because we're finna take Big Mama home. She getting sick, and I can tell. So we want to just get her on home, praise God, and get her situated.
Amen.
Because we just don't want to, you know, just overdo it. Is that all right?
Amen.
I think she done outstanding. Don't you think so?
I think she did it. See, the way you ought to stand and give God a standing ovation what he done.
Amen.
Because I didn't think she was going to stay an hour, but look what time it is. 9:05. Am I right? So I think she did exceeding above and beyond what I asked God to do. God did it through her, and I thank God for what he did. So at this time, praise God, Big Mama, we're going to do the benediction, and Brother Paulin is going to put you in the car and take you on home, okay? Amen. February 205, this is what they took out of Big Mama, this cancer. I don't know, you know, we gave different ones of it, praise God. This is what they took out of Big Mama. Praise God. But we still believe in, praise God, ain't nothing there. Because we have spoken those things that are not as though they are. We have spoken, praise God, health and wealth and prosperity. So the word got to stand because we spoke it. We're not going to take it back. It's got to perform what it's sent out to do. It's got to do the work. Come on, somebody. Amen. Somebody say, I won't take it back. Don't y'all be no Indian giver now. Give it then, take it back now. Amen. So we believe on those principles tonight. So this time when you repeat after me, I am what God say I am. And I can do what God say I can do. And I have. I have. Yes, I have. What God say I have. I have. I have. Amen. 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 God bless you. I love every one of you in Jesus' name. Amen. Hit it, boys.
When your way is dark as night, Jesus will bring things out all right, 'cause he's a friend. I know he'll now until the end. Savior, you should always trust. Don't lose your faith and hope and distrust, 'cause he's a friend. I know he'll now until he
to
great to me.
Yesterday, I decided. more I can take. See, I decided. Side.